Basically, what they are saying is that law is because the judge saying as it is what they are saying. So the law is actually what they are saying. No. Any judgment that is being made by the courts is considered as their law. Yeah, as I already mentioned in class previously, where judges is actually medical realist, they say that law is actually based on what they say. It's not what the what they call it coming from what they call this it's not about how the law is being formulated, and they are not concerned about how what's the second kita testing ya ni lah. Kalau kalau susah nanti kita buat Zoom. I would prefer Zoom. Okay, from this picture, what can you understand? Law is, as I mentioned just now, law is because what they say so. And American realists, they don't actually concentrate in terms of how the law is being created, meaning when it comes to legislative laws, you know, law to them is the law that they apply. It is not something that is being bestowed ataupun is being forced towards them. So they don't like that. And being rebellious people, chances are they just, you know, don't accept it. Okay, because by the end of the day, the decision maker is going to be them. So there is no way that the legislative can come in to say that, hey, you are not doing as what we are supposed to, you know, what we want it to be. So the interpretation of the law or the creation, the legislative, the statute, yeah, that the legislator is creating is not the one that they are concerned with. And they, as compared to sociological jurisprudence, they are slightly different because still they are realists, but they actually not, you know, they don't see the outcome of the decision. Yeah, their decision is not that important towards how it impacts the society. Kalau you tengok compare to Roscoe Pound, Roscoe Pound is more concerned about the effect towards the society, right? So American realists, they just don't want to be concerned overly about that. They are more concerned about the decision that they have. Okay, if you're not clear, you just interrupt me, and as usual, you can ask questions. So basically, this is 19th century punya movement, right? The realism is antithesis of idealism. Idealism is idea based on things that needs to be done based on idea like naturalist, positivist, you know, historicalist. Juris one, you learn about those people presenting their ideas, yeah, that how law is supposed to be. But when it comes to American realism, they don't concern about that. So Max Weber, for example, refused to accept this group of people in saying that they exist, yeah? Even though to the extent of a separate group of jurists. Weber says that this group of people is not worth of for us to consider, because their view of the law is totally different, okay? Even though it is real, according to Weber, it is not something to be recognized because they have the foundation, you know. Because liberalists, they have their own way of interpreting things. Yeah? So they tak ada macam basic foundation of thinking. That is, as the foundation tu tak ada. Because the movement is without a proper methodology, meaning there is no definite basis. Macam kalau kita compare naturalist, everything that people can think of goodness towards the society is something that we need to achieve. Though it might be slightly ambiguous, everyone likes to do good things, but good things can be interpreted in different ways. You know, I like to kill people doesn't mean that you have to acknowledge that. You know, certain people, it might be not be one, but certain culture, say for example, barbaric punya nature like apa nak panggil apa ni makan orang tu, right? Progenies in a situation of a secluded area, dia orang makan orang, so it's their culture, it is a norm for them. So what Weber or the opposition of American realists is saying that there is no proper methodology for American jurists. So where it is stated here that their main concern is towards the law and how it is used by the judges. Yeah. Next slide, kalau kita tengok ke sini, is that it is a movement of analytical positivism. Analytical positivism meaning positivism, but in a analytical manner. Yeah. So, and sociological approach combined. Analytical positivism, meaning if they were to make any decision, right, judgment is from the judge. In a way, they are sovereign lah when it comes to decision of the case, right? So it is a positivism in nature, but it is based on analytical manner. Yeah, they come up with ratio decidendi, orbital dictum, and so on. Yeah, the decision is based on certain analysis of the analytical view. Okay, it is analytical positivism because they look at the law as a product of based on many factors. Yeah? So they will look at the economy, kalau you tengok law of thoughts. Yeah, they look at various perspectives. Yeah? Kalau reasonable man test, it is based on factors that is concerned about how the society behave. If you talk about breach, yeah, breach of duty, so what do you mean by breach of duty? It is something that is based on a certain standard. Yeah. As far as medical negligence is concerned, it is based on what the judges is saying. Kalau kita tengok dulu, kalau kita tengok Bolem, judges are not daring enough to make decision, right? They leave it to the practicing group, the medical people to decide what is the level. But kalau you tengok Kufiana, you know, you tengok Whitakers dekat Australia case, things are changing because the judges says that we decide what needs to be done. Okay, any questions so far? You can unclick the rasa macam tu short sendiri pula. Siti sahaja yang ada voice, tapi orang lain? Okay. Ada anyone wants to, ya Allah, macam apa, stalker pula. Siapa tu? Okay, coming back. Okay, it is sociological because there are factors that influence the law. Obviously, the decision by the judges is actually influencing the society. You know, you like it or not, whatever decision that they make is going to be impacted towards the society. Say, for example, their decision of to towards a child, the decision of who is going to be the guardian of the child, right? So this impact the society itself. in how the child is to be brought up. So for example, the their decision on who gets what, you know, in terms of who wins, who is at fault. So that is something that is something that is sociological in nature. Okay, macam the decision of the courts to penalize Air Asia and MAS, yeah, for them to breach the what they call it antitrust law. Yeah? So they will fine a few millions because they join to agree, you know, you take this part, I take this another part. So that is wrong because you want to monopolize the industry by distributing things between yourself. So it is antitrust law that we do have that. So you can see that it will have the impact to the society. So kalau kita tengok situation of Donahue and Stevenson, right? So a very important case, a landmark case that is actually with that particular case, everything changed. Yeah. Now we see things that is until today, whatever things that we buy, we do have that rights, yeah, to sue the manufacturer, because no matter where they are, we still can sue them. Okay, so the law is more important than the society. To them, it is more towards the law rather than the society, as compared to Roscoe Brown. Roscoe Brown is more concerned about the effect of this, the law towards society. So American rallies, they don't give any importance to law enacted by legislature, yeah, because they are the judge. They are the one that is going to decide whether that particular law is useful or not. So legislature can create so many laws, but the only laws that is going to be applied will be the law that is being used by the judges. So this is because only judges understand the law. Yeah, why they are doing that? Because you can create the law, you can formulate the law, but at the end of the day, who knows what is to be done? Okay, they are the one that is facing the society. They are the one that is day in and day out to look at that particular problem. So, for example, murder cases, you know, rape cases, robbery, you know, contractual relationship. You know, you can create a contract law, but who is going to decide whether that particular law is relevant to this particular case? So the active role is being done by the judges rather than the one that is being the creator, which is the legislative. Okay, so they understand the law more and they understand the society and their psychology effect of their judgment. They are aware of that, right? So dia orang pun bukannya robots, they are people like you and me. And when they make decision, they realize that their decision is going to have a big impact. Say for example, I was informed that Tun Sufian dulu, kalau case when it comes, you know, I don't know whether it is biased or not, whether it is true or not, that is different issue altogether. But when it comes to decision of whether a person is to be recognized, whether the guardianship is belonging to the parents yang Islam or not, the case was pending until by the age of 21, and then the court says, okay, fine, let us make the decision, we are ready to make a decision. And during that decision, the court says, by virtue of the law, the children is supposed to be given to the parents, and the decision that the parents in this particular situation is the one that is not Muslim, right? However, the court says since the children is now 21 years old, he had, or age of majority 18, he can decide what he wants to choose, whether Islam or not. So ada nampak macam bias kat situ kan. But they are implementing their own way of thinking, yeah, the psychology impact of the society. Thus, in a same case applying the same law, two different judges give different judgment. Yeah, so it might contradict with one another, but that is good, whereby they are able to perform their function, i.e. they are the creators of the law. Yeah, because whatever decision by two judges, even though it is conflicting, it is a good nature for the law to be developed. They denounce traditional legal rules and concept and concentrate more on what the courts actually do in reaching the final decision. So legal rules is just a tool. Yeah, to them, legal rules are tools, concept, you know. It is only to be used when they are making that decision. Okay, the tools, it's just a tool. Yeah? One example is that I can say doctrine, apa yang doctrine yang kita boleh pakai, ya? Give me one example of a doctrine. Res judicata, yeah, ataupun voluntae non fit injuria. So those are the maxim that is within the foundation of the law is being accepted by the courts. Yeah, but when it comes to this that particular judge, it is up to him to whether he wants to use it or how he wants to interpret it. So it's quite different. They define law as generalized prediction of the courts will do. Yeah, so it is something of a prediction. Right? So you will, I will explain later on when it comes to prediction of the courts. When it comes to prediction, it can be anything about the decision. So whenever you go to court, you don't know what is the decision of the court. You cannot more or less have it in a scientific way. Sorry, kejap eh. Hai. Untuk itu. Okay, because they are a group of liberals, it's quite difficult for us to like predict the outcome of a case. Yeah, they believe that certainty of law is a myth. Yeah, so certainty is something that is just you cannot rely on. We have to look at the reality of things, because they are only realists, kan? So do you look at the reality of the case itself? It's not about certainty of the law. So, and it's you can predictability of depends on the set of facts which are before the courts for decision. So, if say for example the lawyer tak buat kerja, okay, malas, and fail to bring certain facts to the judge, obviously the judge is going to be towards those people or the opposition that is able to give more evidence. Yeah, so nampak beza dia. Eh? Okay, so kalau you tak reti defend your case, then obviously you will lose, because bottom line is the judge who makes that decision. Though you have a stronger case, you tak pandai argue, you tak pandai bawa facts, and sadly that is going to happen. Like, macam case Najib, right? You see the number of people or what you call it, entourage of all the, what they call it, lawyers that he have, right? The number of lawyers to be able to convince the judge, right? So if you are the opposition, you have only yourself as the person to present the case and you are unable to do your best, then the court is not going to be I mean the judge, yeah, is not going to be in favor of your argument. So judicial activism of the court, meaning courts are very active, yeah, active in making their decision. They like to do things, yeah. For example, I letak kat sini, they reached the peak during Franklin Roosevelt, yeah, punya New Deal, yeah. So this is 1930s, yeah, where economic recession comes in macam sekarang, yeah. So people are pressuring Trump to change the law and create new things. So macam Trump kata buka the economy, but the governors of states kata they are more concerned about the society, so they don't want to open up the economy. So, you know, the lockdown tu dia orang tak nak buat. So Trump is fighting against the governors. So bottom line, it will go to court. Yeah. So if they don't meet halfway, they bekas juga. So either parties can go to the court and for the courts to decide. And in this particular case, New Deal, a situation whereby the president wants to create a certain laws that is able to help the society, but the judge says no. Yeah. So they are very powerful, eh? Especially when it comes to Supreme Court. One of the person that we will be looking at, this is just giving some background, eh? Jerome Frank, law is what the court has decided with respect to any particular set of facts, yeah, that is being presented to them. Therefore, they are going to make that their decision based on that. The opinion of lawyers is only guessing as to what the court will decide. So lawyers can only guess. So they are playing a guessing game. So for example, if you were to have a rape case that your client is being raped, kita ambil Islamic apa panggil Syariah courts, yeah. Syariah courts, we see people who go to Syariah courts akan pakai tudung, yang tak nak pakai tudung, yang pakai kepiah kalau tak nak pakai kepiah, you know. Why they are doing that? They are to try to influence the decision of the judge by appearance, you know. So it's quite difficult for lawyers to identify whether the judge is going to incline towards their case or not. Okay, so they can only guess, and this cannot be treated as law unless the court decide by its judicial pronouncement. So whatever things that you, kalau kita tengok dalam internet, people have their own opinion about certain situation. So you can always argue, you can always gaduh. Tapi the only thing that is going to make a decision is going to be the courts. Yeah, they are the final decision maker. So American realism, as I mentioned earlier on, they are anti-formalist. And this, we will look into Holmes and Llewellyn and Frank's nanti sekejap, eh. Okay, let's look at Holmes. Holmes, Supreme Court judge. Okay, nampak muka pun garang, you know, he has to stand his ground. So kalau you tengok Holmes, he has been described as intellectual inspiration, even the spiritual father of American realism. You know, he's the one that is pushing forward and saying that, yeah, we might be the judge, but actually as a judge, we know the law, we apply the law, we are the actual person that is going to really understand the law, and our decision means everything. So Holmes was skeptical on the ability of general rules to provide solution. Yeah, he said, yeah, you can think, you can create, but the implementers are going to be us. Solution to particular cases and readily give authority to the role of extra legal factors in judicial decision making. Okay, so by putting forward that judges are the one that is going to make decision, he is actually putting forward the factors that judges are not merely as apa kata, as the kata, as a method in the process. Yeah, they are the system. Yeah, kalau tidak macam jadi macam they are just working people. You know, they get salary by the end of the day, so they are nothing to do. In fact, tengok the law and interpret the law and make a decision. No, he says it is not like that. Hume gave the first and classical exposition of the courts in his paper that he created, The Path of Law. Nanti I, kalau I jumpa, I will give you a copy of that for you to look at. Next, we have continuation of that. The life of law is experience, not logic. Juga kan? Yeah, in Juris 1, it's more towards logic. Kalau kita tengok Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, they want people to think in order for them to realize whether the law that you have is relevant or not. Macam Aquinas, yeah, Aquinas is in line with Socrates, Plato, Aristotle, and he says that we have to think whether the law is good or not. But to American realists, they say that life is just an experience. In the experience, the person that is more experienced in terms of how to settle problem would be the judges. Yeah, setiap hari bila masuk je case dekat court, kita dah boleh nampak lah. Yeah, the judge can always anticipate the outcome just like 5 minutes into the case. Nampak macam how can he make that biased decision towards it? That, you know, a person yang dah setiap hari buat benda kan, macam you masak lah, kalau you tengok makanan pun you boleh tahu kata makanan tu sedap ke tak, right? So the law is a prediction of what the courts will decide. Okay, so it is something that law is going to be what the decision of the court. So you can look at in terms of that prediction. So legal history is to be studied to understand how rules develop, and not just because they were laid down by the king, yeah, which they kata which is revolting lah, something, you know. But, so you cannot impose the law towards us. We are the one who knows the law, and we apply the law as what we think is fit. So law must be strictly distinguished from moral. There's nothing moral about it. Okay, so you cannot impose morality towards the judges in terms of how they interpret the law. So they are based on their thinking and experience. Kalau you tengok ni, he is saying that which one is first? Kalau you tengok, the judge is the horse and the theory is the cart. So do you put the cart before the horse or in front of the horse? Then kalau macam ni, the cart before the horse, can you move forward? So you have to have the horse in front of the cart. Yeah, so it makes sense. So he says, Oliver Holmes says about a Batman jury. So what is important in order for you to look at the law? You look from the perspective of a Batman jury. Batman jury is, he says that when it comes to a Batman in court, do he really concentrate on the law? Kita boleh tak agak-agak, you kalau you dah kena tangkap under MCO ni, so you akan tanya under the federal constitution punya rights, where this case, that case, you know, since you have some kind of knowledge in terms of law. No, you, the most important thing to you is to get things, you know, to save yourself. You just want to get this over and done with. So you just want to get out from the situation. So that is Batman theory. Yeah. So from a perspective of a madman, so he doesn't care about anything else. He doesn't care about what prohibition, section, doctrine, you know, principle. He don't care about that. It's just about the outcome. So the same thing with the courts. Law is simply about staying out of jail and avoiding the payment of damages. Yeah? So, kalau lah kata American realist, you don't look about apa yang judge, apa yang judge pakai, apa yang principle dia pakai, apa dia punya argument. No, by the end of the day, the most important thing for the judge is actually the decision. So, okay, that is Holmes. Now let's look at Llewellyn. Okay, it's also a judge. So he says that a court is doing its duty when, with clear consciousness, that it understand what it is doing and why. Okay, and with clear statement of both, it goes to bat on the whole broad situation. Because when judges understand the situation, what do you mean by judges understand the situation? Yeah, kalau you do in a daily, kalau you are a criminal court judge, if you are a criminal court judge, so you tiap-tiap hari you tengok benda yang sama, right? So bila you buat benda yang sama, you become an expert. So with this so-called clear understanding of the situation, of the nature of the law, then you are going to be able to use it as a bad meaning, as a means for you to start, settle the problem. Okay, he mentioned about paper rules and real rules. Yeah, so with regards to statute, precedents, are just mere rules. They are just paper rules. Yeah, real rules are the one that the courts needs to discover and bring into light. Okay, so for example, kita ambil apa? I don't know about properties, for example, right? So it is based on argument of the courts, based on the discovery of the courts. It is not about the paper rules that dictate how the judge needs to be doing their job. Another example is Fufiana punya case or Whitaker punya case dalam talks. So the judge is making a decision saying that no, you cannot force us to have a standard or practicing in the sector that you are having, say for example medical practicing sectors. Do you still remember cases with regards to thoughts? So when it comes to standards, judges are not daring enough to make a decision to say that this is the standard. But when it comes to later cases, the court says that we are going to decide based on knowledge of law. Okay, but not knowledge on medicine, but our knowledge on law, we would implement that. Because kalau you nak katakan, doctors can easily say, excuse me judge, you don't know about the law. You don't know about the jargons of medical punya terminology, the processes involved, the medicine that is being used, whether it's toxic or not, who are you? You don't know anything. But the court is saying that even though we don't know anything about your area, but we are looking from the perspective of all other areas. Yeah, when it comes to justice, we know justice more than you, obviously, because you're just practicing your art, which is medicine. So we know more than that, because when we apply the law we apply is applicable to every sectors, hotel, manufacturing, engineering, building, and so many sectors that we are handling. We are the one that is going to decide whether that particular standard is relevant or not. So now we have doctrine of informed consent. Where does this doctrine come from? Decision of the courts. Kalau you tengok duty negligence, right? Where does this negligence punya principle comes from? It is from the decision of the cases, i.e. Donahue and Stevenson. So there must be duty, there must be breach, there must be damage. So paper rules do not explain the reasoning process to judges' decision. they are just there as a tools. Who is going to be able to explain about the applicability of the law or paper rules? It must be judges lah, which is actually real rules. Ratio decidendi provide mere paper justification. Real rules are therefore the foundation of the judicial decision. Yeah, so you can have a ratio decidendi, the decision of the case being decided by the courts. Yeah, but you realize later courts or later judges do not have to agree with the decision of the previous judge. Okay. Yeah, we do have binding judicial precedent and so on, but as far as the law is concerned, it changes. Yeah, it changes over time. It changes over looking at the facts. Sometimes you see cases when it comes to land law, it is something that is nampak macam eh, how come sekejap macam ni, sekejap macam tu. So who is going to make that decision is bottom line is the judges. Bar counsel selalu bising lah on the decision of the judge. It's not fair, it's not. So who cares? Bottom line is the judge who make decision. Next kita tengok. The real rules are predictors of the court's result. So kalau you understand what is real rules, then you should be able to predict the decision of the courts. Yeah. So paper rule fails because legal rules are made flexible for future application. Okay. So legal rules are real rules that is going to be able to apply for the situation that prevailing in our society. Okay, paper rules, they are not real. Yeah, they are just letters on a piece of paper. Okay. Thus, lawyers are unable to predict judge decision. Yeah, so judges try to influence the judge, but kalau bottom line is about the judge, themselves, they are the one who is going to make the decision. Sometimes to the extent that kadang-kadang kan, ada one of the writers, Carl pun pernah kata, actually, macam mana you nak influence? You have presented the best possible defense ataupun case to try to win your clients. But pagi tu bila dia makan, dia makanan dia tak, you know, the experience dia untuk breakfast tu dia tak apa. He was not happy with the breakfast, mood they're off, you know. Bila mood they're off, he tends to be a person that is very strict. So the moment you datang dengan kata, maaf, saya tak ada bawa hari ni, my document and so, immediately you can see that the case is thrown out as compared to other people. Other people kadang-kadang case, other people maksudnya other lawyers lah. Selalunya dia lenient, tapi when it comes to this particular situation, no, the outcome is totally different. So susah sikit lah ya, in that situation. That is what real rules are. So paper rule fails as judges may not want to apply the rules. Yeah, sometimes macam mana you kata judge, you have to listen, this is the law. Dia kata peduli apa? Tak adalah dia kata peduli apa, but more or less dia kata I disagree, I don't want to, that law is not relevant to this particular case, the decision is based on certain things like that. Okay. So it is the business of the law. Yeah, the key word here, Liu Ling is saying that it's actually the business of the law to do what is right. Yeah. People in charge, say for example, judges, sheriff, legal clerks, jailers, lawyers are officials of the law themselves. Yeah. So it is not only one person, as what Holmes is saying, it's just the judge. Yeah. But here, Lilian is more relaxed. They get it is based on the business of the law to come up with something that is right. Okay. So you see cases in order for a person to be sentenced for the offense that he committed, it is actually based on all the people that is related to the case itself. It started with the police, how they capture and then how do they bring the evidence. Sometimes you see police, they have no knowledge of evidence, how to gather evidence, habis. The evidence is corrupted, tainted. So the opposition lawyer can easily put up their case and convince the court in saying that the evidence is not relevant or cannot be used. So what they do in dispute is considered as the law. So you tengok case mana-mana sitcom atau sitcom mana-mana video or things dalam macam mana nak panggil movie ke, when it comes to law, you will see how actually things is going on in terms of, sebab nature kita that is the nature of judges, that the system that we apply. So kita walaupun pakai adversarial, gaduh between two parties, but at the end of the day, who is going to make the decision? It's going to be the judge. Kalau inquisitorial punya sistem, sama juga. Kalau kita tengok dekat Indonesia, Netherlands and many European countries, they are civil law. So they apply inquisitorial punya nature. That is where you see judges play a bigger role. Though they have the civil law to guide them, but eventually they are going to be the one that is making the decision. Law as an institution whereby, as an institution, law is actually having a goal for it to do things. Yeah? The basic function of law as activities around the job is having purpose. What we call is as law jobs. Law is an institution which is necessary in society and which is comprised not only on rules but also contains ideology and a body of pervasive and powerful ideas which are largely unspoken, largely implicit, and which pass unmentioned in the books. Law has jobs to do within a society. Is very few books or very few research has been done in order to understand how legal institution works. Yeah, because it is not something that is clearly written. It is something that is unspoken, implicit in nature. How does judges find works? Because you have that social distancing of the legal fraternity, judges and the society. Judges are not to be close to the society. They have their ethics, they have to be apart because they need to have that so-called the freedom ataupun clear from bias. You nampak cases whereby judges playing or being close to politician, and so that's wrong because you don't know. As a judge, you don't know who is going to come to your court later on. And then it so happened that kalau it is your friend, sudah, So you have that, to have that. But ada yang judge, sampai to the extent that jadi gila, gantung diri. Can't remember his case, nama mama. So dia life dia in seclusion, stressful. So we have no idea about the function of what is happening in their mind. Okay? So this is what Llewellyn is saying. So a law jobs theory, dia kata, law have jobs to do within the society. it is to understand how cases, trouble cases are going to be handled. Garage repair work, meaning kalau you tengok kedai-kedai repair, macam mana you nak solve the solution? You kalau tengok mekanik kan, tengok kalau kereta tu rosak, dia kena buat investigation, betul tak? So dia kena buat testing sana, testing sini, you know, to identify what seems to be the problem. So it's a job of a judge in order for them to understand the situation, and that they scrutinize things. They get all the information from the lawyers, and from the information received, they are the one that is going to do some analytical evaluation of the problem. How to channel conduct so to avoid trouble? Yeah. So what they are, whatever their decision, they realize that it's going to have an impact to the society. As I already mentioned earlier on, so they are people, they are aware of their decision making. You know, for example, Lord Akin dalam Donoghue Stevenson, they obviously know what needs to be done. And he actually knows what needs to be done in order for a job to be carried out by the legal institution. So how authorities are allocated and arrangement of procedures. Yeah? So they know what needs to be done in order for the institution to function. Okay? So directive from the courts, sometimes when it comes to cases being decided, so kalaulah cases of that particular nature selalu kena tendang because evidence-wise that is being brought towards the to the judge is something that is not up to the standard, so it will trickle down to the system, okay? And then the police, having realized that, they can start sending their staff or police officers to study law of evidence in order for them to know what is going to be right for them to do when it comes to materials. Yeah? Next, kita tengok continuing, Lulim, how organization of society to provide integration, direction and incentive. So, meaning as a law job purpose of that legal institution, there is a mission, yeah, how the society is to be organized in order for it to have integration, direction and incentive. So, obviously, they are realists, obviously, right? Doesn't mean that they are gila kuasa. Yeah? You might have the impression that macam ni, dia orang gila kuasa lah. No, you have to remember that they know the law. Okay? Once they know the law, they should be able to identify with the seclusion, with the nature of the society expectation. They are themselves part of the society. So any decision that they make is for the benefit of the society. So how to use a single slogan as juristic method? Yeah. So all law jobs are done better until it becomes a source of new achievement. So this is something that has to be discovered. This is ongoing process. Something of a method that is to be perfected. So from like what? How many hundreds of years that we have? Huh? So we have, say for example, 1,000 years. Eh, when it comes, tak juga lah. Kita boleh letak kata during Socrates pun dah ada court system, right? Socrates pun kena bunuh because of the court punya decision. But so it is a method that is going to be perfected over time. Huh? And nothing is perfect for the time being. So it's an incremental punya build, yeah. It is an incremental punya process towards the betterment of the institution, meaning the institution punya outcome tu, it will keep on pressuring towards achieving the best outcome. One thing crossed my mind, macam say for example, organization to provide integration, direction and incentive. Macam kita letak the case of Muhammad bin Daud, eh? Muhammad bin Daud is more or less not to allow the government to utilize certain laws to punish the opposition. Okay, so they become the mediator of the problem that is being faced by the society. So if you allow the government, which is they are in control of the legislative and the executive, if you allow them who have majority, macam kita have, kalau dia dapat 2/3 majority government, right? So they are in control of the legislature and they are the executive that is very, very powerful. So who else is going to be the defender of the society if it's not the legal institution? The most important person within that legal institution is the judge. Okay, boleh setakat ni? Saya cakap tak nanti boleh boleh faham ke tak faham?
Boleh.
Boleh, sir.
Ada shock sendiri ya. Okay, benda ni record tak? Ya, ada yang record tak? Kena record. Aduh, kalau tak record, sedih. Kesian dengan orang yang tak ada.
Ada je button record atas sosial.
Dah record eh? Oh, ada stop recording. Okay, okay. So, it is being recorded eh. Okay, coming down to Franks. Yeah? So, kita tengok orang yang ketiga dalam American Realism. Jerome Frank is a realist, a lawyer, sorry, a judge. So he is saying other when it comes to role of the judge, there depends on which domain that the judge is belonging to. So kita ada upper courts dengan lower courts, yang tu belajar dalam MLS kan. So that is what he is trying to say. So dia kata, as a realist, he sees the law is being divided into two, which is rule skeptic. Yeah, rule skeptic. You are skeptic towards the rules. Yeah. So here he says that those who are in doubt of the rules of decided cases apply more in trial courts as compared to appellate courts. So here is kita pakai more towards trial courts. Yeah, so rule skeptic is looking at more of the facts. Yeah, so but they're skeptics about the rules. So you don't care about the rules. You look at the facts. So the facts is macam mana? Kita nak buat example. Kalau you lower courts, kalau case mencuri, so you look at the rules or the facts. Now I'm asking you.
Facts.
Yeah, you look at the facts eh. So dia kata saya tak salah. Saya bawa drugs tu. Saya kawan saya yang bagi bag tu. Saya bawa aje. Dia kata minta tolong. Habis. Yeah, the lower court is looking at more towards the facts. Ada tak benda tu in your position? The fact that whether betul ke tak? No. The fact is clear enough to make that person responsible. So the lower courts, they are rule skeptics. Yeah? They look at more towards the facts rather than the rules. Tapi the upper courts, they akan more towards not looking at the facts, tapi they are more towards the rules. They investigate the rules rather than the facts. Okay, anyone who wants to say anything? I dengar macam ada orang nak cakap dia. You can interfere or interject anytime that you want to. Eh? So kalau you tengok this triangle or this pyramid, kalau rule skeptic kat atas, eh, they are more to terbalik rasanya kan. Okay, dia terbalik eh, silap. So rule skeptic kat bawah, fact skeptic dekat atas. So they, kalau fact skeptics, they look at the more towards the rule. Rule skeptics, they are looking more towards the facts. Facts, according to Jerome, facts are not objective. Yeah, so it depends on what judges see or hear when witnesses testify. This is also different from one judge to another. Okay, it is obvious kalau you tengok legal movies ke legal whatever videos kan, It's all depending on the facts. Facts are not objective at all. It is a subjective nature. It depends on how it is being put forward to the court. So this reality of courthouse have to be disclosed, yeah, because without public knowledge of such reality, the needs to reform cannot be made. So if you don't understand about the reality of this this approach by judges, then it's very difficult for you to create new laws. Because this public knowledge don't know, yeah, as far as legal fraternity, you being as lawyers, now you know lah, sebab you dah belajar Jerome Frank punya point of view. But those people in the public, they have no idea what is the position of the courts when it comes to situation. Say for example, I patah balik, this cross my mind. Kalau case to case bunuh, dia pergi lower courts ke upper courts? So obviously dia akan, a certain number of cases in terms of the value akan naik ke atas rather than bawah, right? So the lower court cannot go on the rule, yeah. Kalau lower court duk asyik tengok ni, sorry ya, silap tau. Nanti aku ubah sekarang lah. Okay. Nanti aku bagi rule. Facts. So when it comes to law court, they do not want to look at the rules rather than they want just to look at the facts. Okay, kat mana kita tadi? Sini ya. It is the basic legal myth to think that law can be relatively permanent or be fixed, that law is dynamic, law is something that is flexible. So you cannot be seeing law as a very rigid, punya way of thinking and looking at the law. Because law deals with human affairs, thus absurd to realize or approximate certainty and predictability in law. So it's obvious, yeah? So law is about human relationship. It's real, yeah? Law is something that is real, so you cannot say you have to. Kalau case macam ni, you have to deal it in this nature, right? So in a way, betul juga lah, yeah. But in some certain cases, it might go differently. But why people seek to for certainty in law? Okay. So the question is whether we want to look at the certainty of law, because yalah, kalau asyik judges make their own decision, you know, just because they are the one that knows the law, they don't have to follow the principle of the law, i.e. letters of the law. Paling salah kan? Okay. Macam, say for example, kita ambil contoh. Yang Datin tu yang pukul maid dia, right? So, tiba-tiba bila masuk court, suddenly dia kena not punish and pergi buat punishment yang not looking at the letters of the law. So people will say, apa ni? What is happening? You are as a judge, you have to do your job. It is your job to bring justice. Okay? So how are you bringing justice in this manner? So you boleh nampak in that particular case, there is bias that is being applied. So kalau lah kata kita kata, oh, law can be flexible, it is something that is not fixed, you know, in a way, yeah. Kalau fixed, bila kita nak ubah, bila nak kita nak change the society to a better standard, right? Macam banyak cases yang the court there enough to make that decision to change the standard of the society. But when it comes to flexibility, kena juga ada some kind of rigidity juga lah, some kind of quorum. Mesti ada agreement. So the answer to it would come to our human psychology. So here he says that human are child who cannot avoid the need to for an authoritative near father. So he's coming out with father theory, yeah, where in order for us to be in a way that you can interpret things, eh? Macam kita tengok dalam internet sekarang, eh? Everyone becomes a lawyer overnight, eh? Atau in just a few hours, they are they have opinions about the law. So if you allow the society to make the decision, so susah lah kan? So you need the judges to make that decision. So you need to have an authoritative near father figure. Okay, kalau lah kata dalam family you senang lah, dalam masa COVID ni you are staying close to one another, stress, you know, setiap hari tengok each other character, mana-mana yang kita selama ni tak suka nampak sangat, you know. So baru ni 2-3 kali dah MKN hantar messages that MKN. Kerajaan memandang serius kes keganasan rumah tangga dan penderaan sepanjang tempoh PKP, salurkan aduan kepada PDRM. So the situation is real. When you are staying close to one another, though you love it one another, but kita ni manusia kan, kita ada karakter, bad karakter that the other, our partners tak suka. So you see tension comes within your family. So in order for problems, ini kita ambil contoh di mana adik-beradik you and your brothers and sisters having some problems with one another, who is going to decide? You need to have an authoritative father to make the decision. Sama dengan kau lah. So eventually, if you have a problem in the society, you need to have a judge to make that decision. Human does try to find law as a substitute to attributes like firmness, sureness and certainty. So society, bila kita dalam keadaan chaos, kita dalam keadaan masalah, kita rasa macam everything is not happening as what it should be, who do you go to? So macam I teringat, who do you go to when you have a problem of ghost? So you go to Ghostbusters lah. Yeah, still remember. Who do you go to when you have problems? So in this situation of firmness, sureness and certainty, so obviously you go to the court. Therefore, a man is always biased and therefore no one is ever had a fair trial and no one will be. Yeah. Okay. Moving on, kalau tengok, justice is what the judge ate after breakfast. This is what I mentioned just now. When it comes to rallies, American rallies, especially when it comes to Jerome Frank, he mentioned that be careful. Yeah, be careful as a judge. He is also a person, and he might be the one that is going to be affected. Though he has a job in order to bring justice, but being a man, you have to realize that also.